Hi there, thanks for watching my video. That's me, swimming along, filming underwater footage, one of my favorite things to do in this world. The other day I was swimming out in Cane Bay and I noticed a shark down below, which is not that unusual, but it wasn't all the way down to the bottom, which is where we normally see them. They were a little closer up to the surface. Then I see another one right about now. There it is, see down there? And there were, oh, there's another one. So there were three swimming up high towards, oh, take that shark, towards the surface. And see all these fish? Okay, now I'm scanning, where'd they go? Where are those sharks? Three sharks, there we go, there's one. And see the big fish? Those are deeper, I'm not sure what kind they are, but they're deeper pelagic fish, deep water fish. Oh, there's another shark. And apparently the sharks had just killed a fish or two, or I don't know how many, but there were fish guts all around. See all the stuff in the water? That's fish guts. Ooh, yeah, oop, yep, gross. Yep, I'm swimming through fish guts at this point. And I'm trying to keep an eye on all the sharks. And I wasn't too worried. I was just keeping an eye on them. I knew if one came right at me, I would put my hand out and put it on his snout and direct it down. That's what you do if a shark swims right towards you. You don't freak out, you don't run away, you don't act like a victim. You just stand your ground, look him in the eye, take your hand out, push it down, like push their snout down as they come towards you, and that redirects them away. So I was ready to do that, and I also figured, all right, let me just gradually mosey on out of this area of sharks and feeding frenzy, because probably not the best place to be. But it was fun, and I enjoyed it, and it was really cool to see the sharks that close up. Then on another day, my friend Nancy and I were in the shallows, real shallow. We like to snorkel after our swim. We swim about a mile in the mornings and then snorkel. And we found this, or we came across this little baby hawksbill turtle. Look at this little cutie pie. He was probably, his shell alone was maybe 8 inches long. I've never seen one this small. It was the coolest little guy, and he was curious about us. He was checking us out, and his shell is very pretty, and his head is bigger, like in proportion to his body, I noticed, than the full-grown hawksbills. I'll show you a full-grown hawksbill next. So he just checked us out. Here's a sea fan. We have lots of beautiful sea fans in Cane Bay, and that coral is fire coral, which I think is really beautiful. You don't want to touch it though, because it will give you a bad sting and rash. Not good to touch. You don't want to touch any coral anyway. And then I followed him. He took off and followed him over here. I'd never chased turtles. I swim parallel to them and keep myself very calm and cool, and that just keeps them calm too. Then I dove down a little bit to get a little closer view. And he's about to go in this hole in the coral. And there's actually a lobster in there, which you can't see in the footage, unfortunately, but there's a big lobster in there. And for your viewing pleasure, here is a large hawksbill, a male hawksbill turtle. See the tail in between his hind flippers? You can hear me talking to him through my snorkel. And this one was particularly curious. Watch this. I love this. I think he sees his reflection in my mask. And he thinks it's another turtle, maybe. But if you're really calm, like just calm and mellow energy, they'll come pretty close to you. Just give them space to breathe. If they seem sketchy or skittish, then make sure you back off. That was Art, to give you some art of swim buddy of ours, give you a little perspective on his size. Bye. Love you. And these are my little squidly buddies. They're so cool. Watch this. One's going to attack the other. Boom. I don't know what that was about. Maybe they were vying for my attention. I'm not sure, but they're so friendly and so loving, and to me anyway, and usually to each other too. I don't feel any weird energy about them. I just feel cool, conscious, high vibe energy from Squid. Almost telepathic. I don't really get messages yet, but I definitely feel like they are capable of telepathy. I need to catch up myself. Okay, do you see it? Look closely. This is a surprise. There it is. It's an octopus. They are the coolest creatures, I tell you. This one's day hunting, which is a really special thing to see. See those fish hanging out with it too? Oh, and swimming, something we don't get to see very often. An octopus swimming. Very cool. And see, she's putting her arms down the holes looking for shells. And she'll swim again and find some more holes, put her arms down. She'll pull out the shells, eat whatever's in them, the clams, mussels, whatever's in them. And she eats them. She takes them to the center of her body where her mouth is, eats them, and then discards the shells. So if you want to find an octopus, look for a bunch of shells discarded and or these brown fish that you see. They hang out around the octopus or octopi. Oh, and these are some more squid. Now see, they're brown. That gives you an idea of how much they can change colors. I've seen them pink. Look at that. There's the almost like a white translucent. I've seen them pink, brown, kind of purpley, and clear. They're really cool. Very neat beings to hang out with. If you get a chance, do it. Aw, such little cuties. That's the reef you hear in the background, too. And then I just love water. This is the surface of the water, and I thought it was so pretty that day. I just thought I would film the surface of the water, see the clouds up above. So peaceful and pretty. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it and would appreciate a like and a subscribe to my channel. And you just create a wonderful, beautiful day for yourself. Remember, it's always a choice. Sending you lots of love. Enjoy.